Bill Ryder, Leeanne Tweeden hanging out with you. We got the whole crew, Michelle, Vic, J-Stu, Kevin figures.
And then another crew.
There's like cameras and lights all around Leeanne.
Focus magazine.
It was Leeanne, what moved you in the show today?
Well, what moved me is really what's moving me this weekend. I know we've had a really good time on the show, but it is Memorial Day weekend. And I'm the daughter of an Air Force guy, and I'm married to an Air Force pilot. And I just want to say thank you to everyone who has sacrificed and lost their life for this country. That is what Memorial Day is. It's the people who never made it home. So thank you to everyone that serves in uniform, and especially those that have given up their lives for our country.
Hi, I'm Janine Stang here with Focus TV. Just had a great conversation with Leeanne Tweeden, so make sure you stay tuned and watch everything we talk about. Janine Stang, and we're here with Focus Magazine, and today I'm in studio with host supermodel Leeanne Tweeden, and we're going to talk to you about your life, about the different causes that you're involved with. So why don't you tell us a little bit about how you're a supermodel. Tell us a little bit about that, and then how you ended up being here.
Well, gosh, I've done a lot of different things in my career and my life, but I did start off as a model very young. I mean, I was modeling in catalogs and doing local things when I was just a child. But as I got older, I wanted to be a model, and I was like, wait, maybe this can take me out of Virginia and I can go to LA, where everybody wants their dreams to be big, right? I wasn't quite tall enough to go to New York, even though that was closer in proximity than Virginia. But I knew LA had a lot of different things, and I didn't want to be an actress, which is a lot of things that people sort of mix up with you when you're here. You're like, oh, you're a model. Oh, so you're an actress. I'm like, no. I don't act. That's not my thing. I think that takes a special talent, you know, but a lot of people come out here and they're like, yeah, I can do that too. And you're not really that good. But I did come out here. Fredericks of Hollywood was the first thing I booked when I was, I think, maybe 17. I had to come back when I was 18. And I modeled for them for over 10 years. So from there, I was an athlete in school. I love sports. I rode dirt bikes. I did a lot of different things that were sort of unique to girls at the time that just want to go out and buy purses and you know,
you're get a tomboy.
You know, pedicures and manicures. Exactly. So the tomboy thing sort of turned into me. I won Venus Model Search. Venus Swimwear at the time was the biggest swimsuit catalog in the world. And they had a Miss America that was supposed to come in and like host the television part of it. The year after that I had won, and they're like, well, she had to cancel, she had a commitment in like South America, can you host this show? And I'm like, sure, it's not that hard, you know, I could talk, I'm comfortable on camera. But my first real break, I did a fitness show on ESPN called Fitness Beach, so that was my first sort of foray into television, and I was the first woman to ever announce Supercross, so I came in sort of the extreme sports way and fitness and things like that. But a huge fan, and then my big break probably that a lot of people know me from is the Best Damn Sports Show period with Tom Arnold and Chris Rose and John Sally and a lot of those guys. Wow. I did that for a lot of years, you know, almost 10 years. So that for me was sort of a you know, groundbreaking moment as far as like, you know, being in the sports world and being on television every day and just having a lot of fun with it.
If there were people out there watching and saying, I'd love to have a career like you, what are the things that you would...
I say pick your thing. That's definitely one of the things. I remember an agent from William Morris who found me when I was really young. I was 18, and she said, look, we want to represent you out of New York, which was great. I mean, I got William. That's the hardest thing for a lot of people who come to a town is to even find an agent. They don't realize how hard that is. And what I say, especially for women in sports, because there's a lot more of us today. When I first started, there were not very many, and it was very tough. It's still a tough business for women, but it's better now. Do your homework. I always say you got to be prepared because the minute you make one tiny little mistake,
Somebody's
they want to jump on top of you. Every guy is going to be like, you suck. What are you doing on radio? What are you doing on TV talking about it? You shouldn't be here. This is no place for a woman. So this is something I always tell every young person. Just do your homework. Know your stuff. It's so important.
Yep. Hard work, right?
Yes, exactly.
Now, you're also involved in the boot campaign.
Yeah.
So tell us a little bit about what the boot campaign is and how you found out about it and, you know, why you're so committed to that cause.
It's funny. I don't even remember how boot campaign and I got together in the very beginning. I knew about them. I'd done a lot of USO tours. I was very in the mix when it came to being a celebrity supporter of our troops. Even early on in the very beginning, I did a lot of USO tours with Robin Williams, John Elway, Bradley Cooper, Wayne Newton, Kid Rock, Alyssa Milano. I mean, the list goes on and on. So I was able to do a lot of things for our troops. And, you know, one thing leads to another. And what I love about the boot campaign is that they want you to be you, but it's about raising awareness. Mm. You know, they want to take pictures of you in your boots just to say, hey, look, you know, Leeanne Tweeden's wearing her boots. Marcus Luttrell has his boots mm-hmm. on. Dolly Parton has her boots on. Mark Steins, another guy from L.A., he's got his boots on. And it's something that you just do as a grassroots thing mm-hmm. to just show your support, your appreciation, mm-hmm. because we all know in the world of advertising, short attention spans. People see an image. It's all about Instagram these days, really. Right. You know, it's like, oh, I see a picture. It's like, oh, wow, they're wearing boots. So they have to support the troops and mm-hmm. what they do. But the boot campaign takes it even farther. And Johnny Jones, who I love, that's one of the guys that's part of the boot campaign.
Push-ups.
Double amputee. He does push-ups for charity. Mm-hmm. Exactly. You know, when you see somebody like him who's walked the walk and lived it mm-hmm. and now is part of the company and he really spearheads getting out there, letting celebrities know what it is that they do, what they do for the families, what they do for troops, do for people coming home, for the children. It's something that when they go, hey, you want to get your boots on and take a picture, it's really hard to say no. I don't think anybody's ever turned them down.
So obviously you're very patriotic. What is your tie, obviously?
Yeah,
families.
My dad served in Vietnam, and it's funny because when I was little, I remember I was about 7 or 8 years old, and I found a box of photos that my dad had, and they were old little square black and white photos with like the little edges cut out that they used to print back then, mm-hmm. and there was one of Raquel Welch, and it was signed to my dad, it was like to Bill, you know, love Raquel or whatever. And I'm thinking, I'm like, is this real? I'm like, how did you meet this movie star, uh-huh. this model, you know?
Yeah.
And he's like, oh, I actually met her in Vietnam. And I'm like, why would you meet her? Why mm-hmm. would she be in Vietnam with you?
Yeah.
And he was like, well, you know, Bob Hope would go over and
so
take
the troops.
Yeah. So I didn't even know. I was like, the USA. He's mm-hmm. like, no, the USO. So yeah. I really learned sort of about Bob Hope taking over different people to entertain the troops. And my dad was like, look, for that moment in Phan Rang, when Bob Hope show came, they landed, there comes out Raquel Welch doing her little dances and stuff on the stage, Bob Hope telling jokes. He goes, we sat in that field and for like 2 hours, I forgot where I was for a second. And my dad was very young, you know, he's like 18. And he said, you know, it really, that to him meant so much that he felt like people at home really cared. Mm-hmm. And that touched me just as a child. I mean, literally, I was like 7 or 8 years old mm-hmm. the first time I heard that. Yeah. So fast forward on, I mean, I always grew up in a patriotic household. Yeah. I'm a Southern girl. I mean, you know, country was always very important to us. And, mm-hmm. and that's just something I learned from him. And then I come to LA and, you know, we have troops, you know, it was like in Kosovo and Bosnia and things like that. So I had done a couple USO tours there. And then 9/11 happens. And I just remember getting the phone call the first time from the USO, the very first time. And they're like, hey, we heard maybe you might want to do a USO tour. And I was like, oh my God, just because my dad had a USO tour, I just thought this was something. I mean, the minute they're like, do you have a passport? I said, yes. The minute I did, I hung up the phone. I'm like, Dad, guess what? Guess where I'm going? They asked me if I wanted to do a USO tour thing. And people ask why you do it. And let me tell you, once you go once, I've been 16 times around the world to visit our troops in war zones. I've been shot out. I've had rockets miss our helicopters by feet.
Wow.
And it's always been worth it. It's always been something that I'd rather die and go out in a blaze of glory out there visiting our troops than to be hit by a car jogging down the street in Beverly Hills.
That's awesome. Well, thank you so much for everything you shared, and we're all definitely going to check out the boot campaign, and thanks for all what you continue to do.
Absolutely, and your voice, and you singing the national anthem for people, thank you for your patriotic self.
Same thing,
beautiful.
Family grown.
That's right. Thank you.
Bursting out the seams. Put me on check.
guys. I'm Leeanne Tweeden. Make sure you get your boots on just like I have mine on in Focus Magazine. You can go to bootcampaign.com to purchase yours, and it's all for a good cause. Thanks for your support.